Hello everyone, how's it going? I'm Wack Crendor, and welcome back to another episode of World of Crendor, a show where I answer the questions you've submitted me on twitter.com/Crendor and facebook.com/Crendor. It's been a while since I made a World of Crendor, so here we are. But I just felt like answering some questions. I felt like channel's been kind of all over the place, so I might as well make a little Q&A on top of just a little update. So one thing is Crensloth shirts are back. We are working on sweatpants. Ever since the maker shop, whatever, got shut down. It used to be called makershit.com. That was Jesse's idea. It wasn't their actual name. It was just the URL that redirected. Ever since they went down, I've been trying to find a new merch partner. And so, I finally got somebody. And I wanted somebody that does sweatpants, and so we're working on getting sweatpants, and it's going pretty well, but we're waiting until they release a new line of sweatpants, similar to the Crensloth ones, which would be, I believe, October. So we're eyeing up probably around a late October, early November pre-order type thing for sweatpants. I'm curious if you'd want the old Crensloth logo, if some people missed out on it, or if you just want an entirely new Crensloth. I still like the sloth idea because it's like sloth sweatpants, like lounging around. You know what I mean? So maybe if we like redesign the sloth, maybe he's like hanging on a branch or something. I don't know, just hanging in a different way. We're thinking of ideas, but for now, the old Crensloth logo is back on a shirt. So if you've wanted some sort of Crensloth merch for a while, that is available. You can check it out. I'll put the link in the description. Crensloth.com. It's easy. Better than makershit.com. The only downside is we haven't found a partner for like international shipping. So if you're not, by America or in America, it's probably going to cost a decent amount for shipping. So I'm sorry about that. We're trying to fix it. We're hoping we find some sort of thing. But if you are in America, I believe there's a code. It's like free shipping. If you use the free shipping code, you get free shipping. I think that's what it is. I'll put it in the description anyway so you'll know what it is. Aside from that, let's get started answering some questions. Question number one comes from Roxas KBM and says, are hot dogs a sandwich? I'm pretty sure this is some sort of Northern Lion inside joke. Some sort of egg joke, because I saw Northern Lion tweet about hot dogs. I've gotten multiple hot dog questions, so I figured I had to give my opinion on it. Are hot dogs a sandwich? No, they're not a sandwich. Okay, it needs to be made clear. Hot dogs are not a sandwich. I mean, you can say like, oh, but it's bread with meat in between it, and that defines a sandwich. Well, I don't think so. My definition of a sandwich is the style of bread, the style of meat, all right? And to me, a hot dog is a hot dog, all right? It's its own thing. It's not a sandwich. It's a hot dog. I mean, you got brats, you got Italian sausage, you got all those types of things. But really, a hot dog's a hot dog. Because then you're going to have to branch out. Is a bratwurst a sandwich? No. It's not a sandwich. It's wrong. Whoever says it's a sandwich, it's not a sandwich. There needs to be some definition that defines what is a sandwich by definition. Hold on. Let me pull this up. Sandwich definition. An item of food consisting of two pieces of bread with meat, cheese, or other filling between them eaten as a light meal. All right. So, to me, right, that means the meat of that sandwich is entirely covered by bread, all right? A hot dog is only partially covered. That's only partially covered meat. And so when you think about it like that, I think that can redefine a sandwich, okay? Like a ham sandwich, unless you have little bits of ham, like, spilling out the sides of the bread, it's a sandwich, right? All the meat's covered. Hot dog, that's the meat is resting in the bread. It's not covered by the bread, okay? And a bun can technically be considered one piece of bread. So you know what? Hot dog's not a sandwich. End of conversation. Post your comments and thoughts down below. All right. So that's that. Next question comes from Clueless Jordan. Do you like video games, and how many pets have you had? No, I hate video games. I don't play any because they're very dumb and boring, and for nerds, I'm not a nerd. How many pets have I had? Let's see. I had a goldfish when I was very young. I had a dog when I was very young. Then we got another dog, which that was like second grade, and so that was like my main pet. That dog was alive from second grade until like I think the end of high school for me. So she was like 11. And then after that, we got another dog, which my parents still have that dog, but I moved out like a little bit after they got her. So I'm not like, you know, it's not like technically my pet. Like the other dogs I lived with every day. So it's like you live with them every day or whatever. This one I always see like when I visit them or whatever. But now I have Cat, who was my first cat, and, you know, he's a cat. So that's, that goldfish, I guess a third dog, technically, that still counts, and then, a cat. So that's like five pets. I've had five pets. So yeah. next question from Move With Haste. As a Guild Wars 2 player, is there any room in your world to play another MMO? Obviously the answer, no, but on the off chance, it's yes. Well, I don't think it's an obvious no. I mean, I played Guild Wars 2. I have, I had a max level prior to this past expansion in Guild Wars 2. And here's the thing. Well, I'm drinking water. Here's the thing. I like Guild Wars 2. I like Guild Wars 2 a lot, but it's one of those things where I end up just going back to WoW. I'm probably going to play the new Guild Wars 2 expansion, especially if like people I know play it, like Gmart or like some other people. That's the main thing. That's like the biggest deciding thing is if people I know play the game. That's what gets me to play the game. Like Guild Wars 2 at first, I played it because Jesse played it and we just leveled together. So that was that was the main reason I played it then. And, like, out of all the MMOs I played, I think Guild Wars 2 is probably my favorite outside of WoW. And you don't have a monthly subscription for it, which is really cool. So yeah, I think there's a chance I'll pick up the new expansion and play it. Next question is from Dookiefied. I start uni in a little over a week. Do you have any tips for me? I'm scared AF. Let's see. Tips. Well, I guess it's hard for me because I never went to a university. I just went to community college, which was essentially just a glorified high school. You know, you would have to drive there every once in a while, take your classes, and then drive home, whatever. I guess uni, you actually have, like, a dorm or, like, you live there or stuff. Unless you, you know, get like an apartment or something. Listen, I don't know. I have no experience in that. But I do know that much like a lot of things, it's only a part of your life. And it's training you and educating you for whatever job or field you want to go into. And that's really when the biggest part of your life starts. So, I mean, all the things in uni, like meeting people, like going out and being like, I guess doing whatever and then trying to make friends or like taking your classes, like whatever you're doing. I think you need to focus more on just the school part, right? Just making sure you do the best you can. Cause I've known a lot of people that go to university and they party a lot and, they're not doing as well right now, and they wish they would have tried harder and that they could get another chance to go back and not be in debt and kind of at square one where they started out. So that's the main thing. But I mean, on top of that, if you're taking classes you like and, you know, doing things you want to do, you're going to meet like-minded people in that aspect, right? If you take a class for like computer science or something, you're going to meet other people that are into computer science. Then you might be like, oh, hey, you play WoW? Like, oh, yeah, I play WoW. And there you go. Right? It's just a human social thing. I don't know. like, for example, all my friends I made through YouTube and WoW, and like that's the main thing. We're playing video games. And it just so happens that those are like my main friend groups at this point. It's just a lot of people I've met online. And sure, some of them are like long distance. I do have my normal friends like that are close to me that aren't just long distance friends I see every once in a while. But, you know, I have various friends for various things on top of that. Like, obviously, I have my video game friends. I got my YouTube friends, Twitch friends, like, you know, all that. And then, like, in real life, I got one friend who's just really into sports and stuff. And so I just talk to him when we want to go see sports. It'll be, like, Sunday, and he's like, hey, want to go to a bar and watch a football game and eat a hamburger? And I'm like, okay. And we do that, and then I don't see him for another, like, 3 weeks. And I'm like, hey, want to go do that again? He's like, yeah. So, I mean, that's what it's like for some people. You don't have to be, like, best friends with everybody, you know? And that might lead to meeting other people or meeting other friends. You never know. You know, you could have someone who's really into movies. You're like, hey, let's go watch a movie. You want to talk about this movie. You could have someone who's just, you know, just whatever. All right. That's about where my experience ends on the subject. Because, again, I haven't actually gone to university. And so it's probably better asking some people in the comments or wherever you can get advice from on that topic. But yeah, don't be scared. It'll be all right. You got the rest of your life after that. Next question comes from Axon303. Just how much of an old man is old man force strategy? So, old man force Overwatch gaming is a pretty old man, and I think that's why I like him so much. Talking about friendships, Force is probably one of the oldest people I know at like 31 years old, and I think that's why I relate to him so much. He's just a very normal person, you know. He goes to like the docks to eat his deli sandwiches, locally organically grown. He rides his mini scooter. He's just like a hipster normie guy, but I think that really suits him. He's like a true dad, like a true dad, more so than even Sips, I would say. So, great guy for strategy, very old. Next question, Real Aurora Sore asks, design your own micro holiday, go. Oh God, I picked out this question yet, I didn't think of any micro holidays. Okay. Let's see, micro holidays, Christmas, let's see, what do I like? Probably, what do I always think of? Maybe some sort of zombie dragon day. It'd probably be a zombie dragon day, where the zombie dragons, like, fly around somewhere, and you can go watch them, and they, like, breathe fire, and it's just, like, a little spectacle. Maybe you get to ride one. You can ride a zombie dragon. That might be a cool little micro holiday. I mean, you don't have to have any rewards for that. It's just got to be some cool in-game thing, you know? Oh my god, maybe winter, spring or something? You could have a snowball fight there. There we go. Put up a bunch of, like, forts in winter, spring, and you could just have snowball fights where you, like, knock people down. You can... Maybe you have, like, a snowball, like, gun, and you shoot people with the snowball gun, and then they fall down, and you can have laser tag-esque battles at the snowball forts or something. That'd be really cool. Oh my god, why hasn't that been a thing? There we go, I got it. Snowball Wars. Come on, Blizzard, get on this. Lego Man Jay with the next question. If WoW could implement any sort of content, what would you absolutely love in WoW or on a regular basis? Oh, on a regular basis. I still would love either guild halls or player housing. And I think they're going to add it very soon. I think so many other games do it, and they do it pretty well. And people have just wanted it for so long. And I think Blizzard has just a giant plate of potential in front of them they're not taking advantage of. I mean, so many people love the aspect of like having a building with your friends or to yourself where you can decorate it and change stuff around and look at things and compare stuff like achievements. You could have your guild bank in there. You could have like your own and you could have little custom like garrisons, but not bad. You know, it'd be like garrisons, but just not bad. You wouldn't exclude everyone. You can invite people into your house or your guild hall. You can encourage community stuff. You can get designs like, say, maybe a micro holiday gives you some sort of chair design. I don't know. Maybe you can put plaques up in there. Maybe you kill Hogger and you can put Hogger's head on the wall and on a plaque or something. Be like, there's my Hogger head I killed. And everyone's like, wow. Or you could put up bosses you killed and put plaques of them up there. You could have various types of furniture or stuff you can swap around. Like, it doesn't have to be complex or anything. It's like, hey, here's different types of tables, different types of chairs, and you can move them around on this pre-made grid we've given you. Like, just stuff like that. And I think that's what I would really like, because that encourages you to play with your friends and meet with your friends in the game, and any type of community-driven interaction in a massively multiplayer online game is, I'd say, to be encouraged, instead of, hey, what if we take out community-driven things in our online role-playing game? Like, what if we call it garrisons? You know, that's what you end up with. It's like, what if we just do the opposite of garrisons? Not that hard. Then again, they'll probably mess it up somehow. But I think they could do it. And I hope they do. So that's what I would like. Next question is from Roka Star, and they say, how are you feeling about what the Chicago Bulls have been doing, and how do you feel about them going forward? I'll answer this answers quickly because I know people don't really care about sports that much, but I did want to answer it. I thought the Bulls were good. They did the right thing in dealing Jimmy Butler, but I think they should have got a little bit more for him. I think they should have kept their other first-round pick. I think that's the biggest thing. They should have kept their other first-round pick, and then it would have been a good trade. They could have drafted another guy, been ready to rebuild a bit more, and then go into next year drafting, hoping to get one of the superstar guys that are going to be available. Otherwise, I think they did the right thing. They're not going to win the championship anytime soon. You know, it's going to be Golden State, Boston, Cleveland, you know, the big guys out there, San Antonio, some of those other people. So, build for the future, man. I'm glad they did that. Next question is from Felipe Spaten. In the middle of all this Legion rage, can you point out all the good things that you think Legion brought us? I personally think it's the best expansion yet, but of course there are some stuff I would change, but I prefer to focus on the bright side of the coin. I talked about this a bit in my last video with the Argus stuff, but I thought Legion was the best expansion we've had in a while. It's probably my favorite expansion I've played since Wrath of the Lich King. Now, that may be because of the people I played with, and the fact that it's the first time I've really raided and played with friends, and I think that plays into it a lot. But I think compared to Warlords of Draenor, Cataclysm, and Mists of Pandaria, I think it's better than all those. I think Mists of Pandaria was probably my second favorite out of the three or four or whatever I'm saying. Just because, I don't know, there's something about Mists of Pandaria where it was like, everyone's like, ah, it's a joke. But it was still a pretty fun expansion. And then Cataclysm behind that. I wasn't really into Cataclysm, but I still played it and was like, all right. And then Draenor was just, I had so much fun for a month, and then I was like, I don't want to play it anymore. And so I didn't. Legion, I think I've just played it the most out of all the expansions since Wrath of the Lich King. Like I was saying, I've leveled two characters to max level. That's the first time I've done that since Wrath of the Lich King. I've come back to play the patches. That's another thing I never did with Draenor. I think they've done pretty well with the patches. I know some people don't think they have. I've enjoyed it from what they've done. And I know the big thing is flying. Everyone's like, why can't we fly? I don't know. Part of me doesn't mind not flying. Part of me is kind of like, all right, they should make flying a little bit easier to get. I wouldn't mind them making it flying easier to get. I think as long as you do the content in the zone, you should unlock flying for that zone. Even if it's, like I said, it's only zone specific or something. Like, oh, hey, you did all the quests in this zone. You got the achievement. Here's flying for this area. But you can't fly in any other zones yet. I think that would be all right. But I guess maybe they're doing it for world dailies or something, or just from a design aspect. I don't know. But I guess not a design aspect, because you can fly if you do the rest of this stuff. It's just, yeah, I don't know. Yeah. Next question. Austin, Miles, what are your plans going forward with YouTube and Twitch? More of the same or any crazy Crendor shenanigans? Twitch is probably more of the same. I've kind of settled in on Twitch. I just kind of play whatever I want. I don't really have a set schedule. I mainly stream at night if I do play anything. But I just play games and have fun. I don't care about getting max viewership or anything. I'm not one of those people like, this game's really bringing in the views, so I just gotta play it nonstop. Like, if I'm not enjoying a game, I'm not gonna play it. You know, if I got the most views playing Hello Kitty World of Swag Auto 5, I wouldn't play it if I was bored with it. But if I was having a lot of fun playing, I don't know, WoW or something, but I wasn't getting as many views, I'd play it still because that's what I want to play. And I think having fun playing what you're playing is one of the biggest things to getting people to watch you. At least once you're established. Like, obviously you need to grow your viewership and stuff once you're trying to grow up to a point where you can establish yourself. But at this point, I'm just like, man, I'm just playing to have fun. And I think that's the best thing you can do. And I think people will notice that on top of it. So, yeah, as for YouTube, I do want to cut back on Hearthstone a bit. I do want to pick up on WoW a little bit more. I still like the idea of making a WoW machinima a week. It's just a matter of doing it. Because I don't want to force anything. I think even a WoW machinima every 2 weeks would be alright. That's still more than what I already do. Because I still, every time I make a WoW machinima, there's just a great feeling behind it. And it just feels good. So, I still want to do that. So, I'd like to iron out some sort of YouTube schedule to keep me on track. World of Crendors. I haven't made one of those in a long time. And here we go. So, I'd like to even do a World of Crendor on the same amount. Maybe like once every 2 weeks or something. And then, as for other stuff, I still like Hearthstone, obviously. But, like, I like playing new tavern brawls. I like throwing together just fun, crazy decks still. I do like playing against other people and doing crazy gimmick stuff like I've done with Hobbs or Rob or whatever. I might do one with Nixium. I think that'd be really fun. And then just whatever else I feel like, you know. But I'd like to get some new series going. I still like fishing with Crendor, obviously. That's another thing, but I would like some other stuff. We need more non-content. I think that's a definite has to happen. We need more non-content. But yeah, I'm just trying to get some more ideas, because I would like to get some fresh, fun, new ideas going, because I feel like it's just a lot of the old stuff keeps getting repeated on the channel. It's kind of like when I started fishing with Crendor, that became such a good series, or Pointless Top 10. I want more Pointless Top 10s to get going. But I would like at least one new series, you know? Whatever it may be, I think that would be the main thing I'm aiming towards. So, yeah. Next question. Antonio Salvador asks, will you ever shave that beard? I don't think so. Mainly because when I shave the beard, I look like I'm 13. But I have started trimming the beard, so I'm sure you've seen my beard in the past where it's gotten Abraham Lincoln length. I do trim my beard now, so it stays at like a solid, normal looking length, so I don't look like I'm completely homeless. But yeah, I like having a beard. I don't know. I just like the look of a beard. That's just what I like. Alicia Lynch asks, what else has been going on in life? New job opportunities, relationships, travel? Yes. I also got similar questions on Twitter. People asked, how's Krenkat Toaster Woman? So I'll answer that all kind of together. Relationships, I'm still with Toaster Woman and or, quote, Mystery Woman. So we've been together it's been like 5 years. I think we got Dodger and Sam beat by a year, to be honest. We're just not married yet. and I'm not one to really rush into or care about marriage all that much. I don't know. I feel like a lot of people rush into it. And it's like, you might as well just chill, you know, chill together, you know, and just enjoy life. And then whenever you're ready, or if you want to, or you was be like, yo, you know, I mean, Force is a good example of that. Force was with his girlfriend for, I think, 8 years, 8 or 9 years. And then they just got married this year. So, I mean, I think it's something society pressures you into a bit, when really it should just be whenever you're both feeling ready in your lives, if you ever want to. So, yeah, but we're still together. Krenkat, he's a cat. He's a little over 3 years old now. He's gotten a bit bigger, but he's still active. He still runs around. He likes to sleep in the sun. He goes crazy every day in the morning, and he appears on stream sometimes, and he's a cat. He eats food, and he's a cat. Job opportunities, I mean, I wouldn't say new job opportunities. It's mainly just doing what I always do, except I guess Twitch has been my, quote, new job opportunity. It's been a combination of streaming and then doing YouTube, and then obviously I get things like sponsorships, starting up the merchandise again. Anything? Oh, I guess Cox and Krendor. If you haven't known or noticed or seen Cox and Krendor in a while, we started getting sponsorships for Cox and Krendor. And it's actually helping us to do a minimum of an episode a week, because when you have a sponsorship, they're like, we want an episode on this day. So it actually helps us to make more podcasts. So I'm glad that we got that. I know some people are like, you're selling out here or whatever, but it's just one of those things where Jesse's always busy. I mean, I'm always free, but having this type of thing there allows us to do it more frequently, because just the sponsorships can help make the time more worth it for him. Obviously for me, because I'm like, sweet, I wasn't doing anything anyway. So yeah, we try to make the sponsorships fun at least. You know, kind of tie them in to what we're talking about, or take sponsorships that are either kind of funny or that we've already used. I know we did DraftKings, Squarespace. DraftKings is kind of the ones where people were like, I don't know, you're promoting a gambling thing. But I mainly did it, or told them yes, because I use DraftKings. And so I'm a big sports person, so I didn't mind doing it. Like, if neither of us used it or whatever, it'd be like, I don't know. But I've used DraftKings for like 2 years. I've just always enjoyed it. I don't know. I like fantasy football. I play DraftKings. I play, what's that other one? Just like Yahoo Fantasy with Sinvicta. We just had our draft tonight, actually. And that's pretty good. The main thing, though, is that, you know, these are my main things. And then I've never wanted to really do a Patreon. I know we did the Cox and Krendor Patreon, but that was just kind of like a, that ended up not doing, that wasn't very good. I'm glad we moved on from that. I'd rather, instead of Patreon type things, we do just like Twitch, like people that give bits on Twitch. Like, to me, that's like a Patreon, and that's why I feel like I don't need a Patreon. Cause just if people are just like, hey, I like your videos, hey, do this or whatever, and they want to support me, they just, you know, they just do it through Twitch. I don't need Patreon. Unless I was doing something crazy, right? Like if I was like, I'm doing a super project and I need all the help I can get, blah, blah. Maybe that's the only time I do a Patreon, but me just being like, hey guys, I just need more money. Like, you know, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to start up a Patreon just for something like that when, you know, Twitch is more than enough of a Patreon, patriotic act. Is that even a word? You get what I'm saying? So that's what I'm saying. So, and I think sponsors are not too bad either, as long as you do it in a fun way. And you don't just do any sponsorship under the sun. I'm the same with brand deals too. You know, I could do like every brand deal out there, but I try to do things that I'd actually enjoy or that I feel like you would enjoy as well. And then travel. I forgot I'm still answering this question. Travel. In a few weeks, I'm actually going to be going to LA. And I'm going to be chilling with all the office people. And Jesse, we'll probably get a new Jesse Fridge video. So that should be a fun time. And then obviously after that, I'll be going to BlizzCon. And those are my two big things coming up. So that's my traveling. And that's that question. Next up, we got Lloyd D. Moore. Take cream in your coffee? No. I drink it black. Straight up black. I just, that's how you get the taste, man. You can't put sugar, don't put cream, you just drink it black. That's how you do it. I don't know, like, it's just weird to me. Like, to me, that's like having a glass of wine and putting water in it or something. Or like ice cubes. Like, I wouldn't do that. Some people do that. I don't do that. You're just diluting the flavor of everything. I just don't get it. And it's what you're doing with cream and sugar and all that. I'm a very pure food person. I don't put salad dressings on salads usually. I don't know. It's just how I am. Frankie Aguilera, ever consider playing D&D for your channel? Not for my channel, but I have done D&D on JP's channel. It Me JP. He does the roleplay show on Twitch. He uploads everything to YouTube. And if you look up Daikia, you will see that I DM'd two things of Daikia with Jesse Dodger and Strippin and JP. So if you haven't seen those, go check those out if you want to see the madness that it was. I also was on a roleplay thing on the same channel where it was a Viking-type roleplay situation with me, Jesse, Maggie, who's Margaret Crone, and Shannon, who worked at Twitch, and we were in this like Viking world and stuff like that. That was like a few years ago, actually. But those were my D&D things. So yeah, just check those out if you like D&D and didn't know about those. And finally, we have Draconis, who says, how's the book going? When are you going to let us give you money for it? The book is kind of like my hobby slash thing I really want to happen. That's like my one big thing I really... It's unlike my non-content RPG where I was like, I'm going to make a game, or like a lot of these things I say I'm going to do or whatever. The book is something I still really want to do. Like, that's my one big... How some YouTube people are like, I would just love to be on television, or like, I just want to be in a movie. I don't care about those things. I really want to write a book that isn't bad. It doesn't have to be amazing, but I just want it to be good, where someone reads it and like, hey, I enjoyed that. You know, it doesn't have to be something like, it doesn't have to be the next Game of Thrones or anything like that, but just an enjoyable book. And so I have been improving my writing. I watch a lot of stuff and kind of working out still what I want the book to be about, which is the main thing. But I'm slowly but surely getting there. Don't worry. I'm not working on the book, right? I'm working on the book. It's a slow process. And I've learned that over the years. I've definitely learned that. Writing a book is not as easy as it seems. But I enjoy writing. I enjoy doing all that. Coming up with characters, scenarios, just the way things can play out, like different types of themes and plots and all that stuff. So... It's kind of like my my little hobby I got going that just happens to tie into everything else I do because I like fantasy and everything. So it's kind of just a mixture of all the types of fantasies and things that I enjoy. Because it's one, you know how when you watch or play a fantasy, like watch or play a fan, like World of Warcraft or Lord of the Rings or any of these types of things where you just get involved with the world and it's the plots and the side characters and you're like, whoa, what's this area they don't really go into detail about? And you start to like think about all that. I love that. I love the world building of a fantasy novel, but I also enjoy the story part. So it's just, I think that's what really motivates me, is just making a really cool world and then having cool stories within that world. Which is, you know, that's writing. But, yeah. Butter. Where am I going? I think we're good. I think this is, we've hit the end. So, thank you for watching and listening. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you got any questions, make sure to follow me on twitter.com/Krendor or facebook.com/Krendor. And the next time I say, hey, I'm making a world of Krendor, go, 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 you can ask those questions and they might get answered on this show. Don't just ask me a question randomly, because that's the main time I check it. Unless you want to, I don't know, man. Yeah, I think we're good. If you want to check out Krenslaw shirts, that's also down below. I'll put the free shipping code down there if you're in America. If you're not, I'm sorry, but it's a cool shirt. And yeah, we're working on hoodies, we're working on sweatpants, all the good stuff's gonna be coming back. Those are the main things I want. And I'll see you next time. Okay. See you.